Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Fusion Industry Association channel. I hope you've had a wonderful holiday season and a very happy new year. My name is Cyd Cowley. I am a PhD student studying at the University of York and working at the Culham Centre for Fusion Energy. Today is Friday, the 14th of January, and I'm here to give you your weekly Fusion News Roundup. Stories today include: 1. Was 2021 a breakthrough year for fusion energy? 2. China's artificial sun just broke a record for longest sustained nuclear fusion. 3. Fusion energy is a reason to be excited about the future. 4. Fusion finance. Could private capital deliver energy's holy grail? 5. Fueled by billionaire dollars, nuclear fusion enters a new age. And of course, I'll have some bonus stories as well. 1. Was 2021 a breakthrough year for fusion energy? To start us off, we have an excellent recap on the state and progress of fusion in 2021. And this article is written by our own Dr. Melanie Windridge and published in Forbes magazine. Now in this article, Dr. Windridge discusses some of the biggest fusion news stories to break in 2021, many of which, excitingly, we covered on this channel as they came out. Now these include scientific breakthroughs such as the advances in plasma exhaust control demonstrated by the MAST upgrade experiment in the UK, the 1.3 megajoules of fusion energy released by the National Ignition Facility in the US, or the 20 Tesla magnetic field demonstrated by Commonwealth Fusion Systems in Massachusetts. Now this article also discusses breakthroughs for fusion as an industry, including the UK government's announcement of its official fusion strategy, or the news that the private fusion company Commonwealth Fusion Systems secured a record $1.8 billion of funding, or the fact that the Fusion Industry Association and the UK Atomic Energy Authority jointly published the Global Fusion Industry 2021 report. Finally, the article highlights statements from key players in the field of fusion about the state and progress of fusion in 2021. These include statements from Ian Chapman, the CEO of the UK Atomic Energy Authority, or Professor Stephen Cowley, director of the Princeton Plasma Physics Laboratory, and Andrew Holland, the CEO of the Fusion Industry Association, just to name a few. If you'd like to know more about what these leaders in fusion are saying, I really recommend you check this article out. 2. China's artificial sun just broke record for longest sustained nuclear fusion. Now this next article covers the first big scientific breakthrough of 2022 in terms of fusion, which is very exciting because we're only about a couple weeks in. This achievement centers around China's experimental advanced superconducting tokamak, or EAST for short. The tokamak recently achieved a fusion plasma at more than 70 million degrees Celsius and held that fusion plasma for more than 17 minutes. Now this really is a leap forward in terms of pulse times for tokamaks, because most tokamaks around the world operate with a fusion plasma that's sustained for the second to millisecond range, not minutes. This is because to generate certain magnetic fields inside tokamaks, you need to continuously vary high currents inside the machine. So it is truly a technical marvel that the EAST tokamak has been able to operate for more than 17 minutes for one continuous plasma. 3. Fusion energy is a reason to be excited about the future. Now this story from Vox is a great reminder as to why we care about fusion to begin with, since it highlights fusion's potential as an incredibly clean, highly available, and energy-dense supply of electricity and heat for humanity. The article also discusses the central challenge of fusion, which is confining a burning plasma here on Earth, and discusses several of the largest public projects to try and overcome this challenge, including the ITER tokamak in France and the National Ignition Facility, a laser facility in the US. Interestingly, the article discusses public funding of fusion in the US, arguing that it is very low and quite erratically funded compared to other projects of similar scope. For example, NASA receives more than 50 times the budget of fusion, and the US military receives more than 1,000 times the entire budget of nuclear fusion research in the US. Quoting fusion scientists, the article implies that more consistent, higher funding for nuclear fusion would pave the way towards cheaper, low-carbon, highly available power for everyone. 4. Fusion finance. Could private capital deliver energy's holy grail? This is another article about the recent influx of private capital into fusion, and this one argues that the sector may finally be ready to deliver. It discusses the promise of fusion and the reason for increasing investment interest, highlighting the progress of private companies Helion, Commonwealth Fusion Systems, and Tokamak Energy. The author, Andrew Wade, highlights that a big motivation for many of the private companies is to provide essential low-carbon energy solutions. David Kingham from Tokamak Energy is quoted as saying, "There's no chance that every country will decarbonize by 2050. Many of them won't even try. So something else has to be done." To me, it's engineering solutions that are going to be crucial, because persuading people to use less energy is not likely to work. 5. Fueled by billionaire dollars, nuclear fusion enters a new age. This Forbes article, written by Christopher Hellman, discusses how the state of fusion has changed through the development of fast and well-funded private fusion companies. In particular, the article focuses on Helion Energy and one of its largest private backers, Mithril Capital. Helion, which uses a field reverse configuration to fuse deuterium and helium-3 atoms, is now valued at $3 billion and is developing its seventh reactor, Polaris. AJ Royan, the co-founder of Mithril Capital, which is Helion's biggest investor, says that Helion's ability to convert fusion energy directly into electricity is one of its biggest selling points, rather than, for example, using the heat from fusion reactions to power a turbine. Also featured in this article is the fusion company Commonwealth Fusion Systems, which is trying to use novel high-temperature rare earth barium copper oxide superconductors to build high magnetic field standard aspect ratio tokamaks. This article really shows that behind the incredible surge of private fusion companies are backers who truly believe in fusion and its ability to change the world. AJ Royan, for example, sees the potential of fusion to revolutionize the agricultural industry, saying, "Think of the opportunities for water desalination and fertilizer production. This fundamentally alters water economics overnight, and thus economics agriculture." Steve Yurvetson, a backer of Commonwealth Fusion Systems, is similarly optimistic about fusion, saying, "There's plenty of naysayers until it's done. Then, they say it's obvious." And to finish off, I have a special New Year's bonus for everyone, and the bonus today is a piece in Gizmodo entitled, "Will Nuclear Fusion Ever Power the World?" They've asked this question to several fusion experts, such as Steffi Diem from the University of Wisconsin-Madison, Derek Sutherland of the private company CT Fusion, and Omar Hurricane from the National Ignition Facility. It's a very interesting question and some lovely answers. I really recommend you check it out. Right, well, that's all for the first episode of Fusion News for 2022. I really hope you enjoyed, and if you did, don't forget you can like, comment, subscribe, and also check out our Fusion News podcast for more information. As always, the links are in the description, and thank you very much for watching.